Hello, Wolfspack. My name is... Actually, that's... gonna do a better one. Hello, Wolfspack. My name is Wolfyboy, and welcome back to Wolfenstein, the new order. I didn't find anything, but maybe I'll find... I didn't find stuff. The last code. But maybe I'll find it later in the episode.
We'll go away from this place now.
God, robot, God robot, that's escalated. Focus down. The development of advanced mechanized war units was one of General Deathhead's major contributions to winning the war. When the war was over, many of these units were redesigned to function as guard units that could be easily transported to wherever needed. So that's what those things do. Wait. Okay. Okay. Oh, nice. Dang it. So there. Okay. No. Okay. Where should I shoot? I'm not sure. Cool, it just fell in itself. Cool. Awesome. Awesome sauce. The sauce is awesome. I can confirm. I got that. Ooh! Action! Ooh. Ooh, action. So much action, I can't handle it. I'm just kidding. Oh, snap, son. Ooh. Cool. So the other one got destroyed in a different way. What? It's in the middle of the night.
Just head back to the cabin. Avoid eye contact.
Okay, I missed the last. I didn't get the last. Code. The Berlin night train. Finally on board a night train to Berlin. Anya wants coffee. Me too. Don't know if she wants milk, so better bring a carton. She's waiting for me in the sleeping cabin. Which way was it again?
Der Ausgang ist gesperrt.
Okay.
Sie können den Kaffee auf dem Tisch abstellen. Es ist harmlos. Stellen Sie den Kaffee auf dem Tisch ab.
Oh. Ja.
Augenblick mal. Lassen Sie sich mal ansehen. Ja. Sehr schöne arische Züge. Findest du nicht auch, Bobby?
Ja, mir gefallen seine Augen.
Bitte, setzen Sie sich. Entschuldigen Sie mein Benehmen. Ich bin Obersturmbannführer Engel. Und das ist mein liebreizender Begleiter. Das bist du doch, Bobby.
Was soll das, mein Schatz?
Ich möchte Sie einem Test unterziehen. Damit lassen sich Spuren unreinen Blutes, die in den Adern einer Person fließen, feststellen. Ich bin mir sicher, dass Sie diesen Test mit Leichtigkeit bestehen werden. Und wenn nicht, dann werde ich Sie erschießen. Haben Sie das verstanden? Das ist nur ein Test! Aber antworten Sie ehrlich. Wenn Sie nach der Waffe greifen sollten, sind Sie tot. Noch bevor Sie Ihre Entscheidung bereuen werden. Gut! Lasst uns anfangen! Sehen Sie das Foto, das Sie erregt. Wenn Sie wissen, was ich meine.
Exactly, he said he liked eyes, so.
Ach so. Und jetzt wählen Sie das Foto, das in Ihnen Glücksgefühle auslöst. Interessant. Meinen Sie, dass dieser Mann unreines Blut hat, Bernhard?
Ich weiß nicht, Frau Obersturmbannführer.
Ja, das werden wir bald wissen, nicht wahr? Diesmal wählen Sie das Bild, das Sie am meisten mit Abscheu erfüllt. Ich hätte sagen sollen, dass das Ihre letzte Wahl ist. Also wählen Sie weise.
Still Spider.
Ich sage Ihnen etwas. Wenn Sie ein Nicht-Arier gewesen wären, hätten Sie zur Waffe gegriffen.
Sie müssen diese Dame schon entschuldigen, aber sie ist sehr stolz darauf, diese Bilderrätsel mit wildfremden Männern zu spielen.
Diese Bilder. Urlaubsfotos. Alte Kriegsaufnahmen. Gar nichts.
No, yes,
davon abgesehen kann ich ein Nicht-Arier mit bloßem Auge erkennen. Du etwa nicht. Lassen Sie ihn gehen, Bernhard.
Ich nehme mal an, eine bildhübsche Frau wird in seinem Abteil warten auf ihn.
Ach, Bobby, lass gut sein. Vergessen Sie den Kaffee für Ihre Freundin nicht.
Danke. Danke. Okay, that was unsettling. Better head back to Anya in a sleeping camp before that crazy nasty lady comes up with a new game. Yeah. train to Berlin. Oh no, wait. Oh, I still have a chance. Ah! Okay, train to Berlin. The Eisenfail is a luxurious passenger train service travel. Never try it again. No, I don't know what this is. Train to Berlin. The Eisenfail is a luxurious passenger train service traveling from the bustling capital of Eastern Europe, Warsaw, through the heart of the German Empire, Berlin, to Zagreb in Annex, Croatia. Built in 1953, it is the fastest train in Europe, capable of reaching speeds up to 200 kilometers an hour. Damn, that's fast. Its fine dining restaurant car has been continuously listed in the Berlin Food Guide since it was established. Frau Engel. She looks better there on that picture. Probably because she's further away. Frau Engel, a leading figure behind the Bund Deutscher League of German Girls, the girls' wing of the Nazi Party's youth movement. Frau Engel has dedicated her life to the Nazi cause, having done her duty raising six, according to every definition, Aryan children to serve the fatherland and exhibiting steadfast loyalty to the Nazi Party. She quickly rose up their ranks. Okay. Where? Totally. This. Yes.
William?
Yes.
Is that for me?
Yes.
You know there's just one bed.
Oh.
Yes.
Are you comfortable sharing?
Oh my.
Sometimes Christmas. Sometimes birthdays. Sometimes mayhem, suffering, and death.
There's
sometimes
no visible things to
feel. Something good.
I'm gonna keep that in. Of course, there was nothing.
I know where to go. The way to get inside Eisenfeld prison.
Okay.
There's a hotel, it's on the same street as secret police headquarters. Everybody knows about it. Secret police
No! God, there was the looks.
They bring prisoners inside for questioning. They torture them. And then they drive them back to Eisenfeld prison. If they're still alive.
Can I actually go back? Only 14 minutes, so I should probably record more. Well, I can probably just restart later, so yeah.
There's a prison transport arriving. Come quickly! They're making a pickup. You find a way to get down on the roof of that prison transport bus. You hide on that roof and you can ride it all the way into Eisenwald prison. I go down and distract the guard. And maybe he won't see you.
Berlin. Eisenwald prison. We're in Berlin now. Anya tells me she knows a way inside Eisenwald prison. There are people locked inside I need to see. Resistance members still fighting the Nazis. My kind of people. I have to get them out of there. Eisenwald. Sneak into the prison transport. Anya is distracting the guard by the prison transport parked on the street below. That tall building next to it is the secret police headquarters. If I get in there, I could find a way onto the roof of the transport vehicle. Have to stay low and make sure they don't see me. Secret police headquarters. To facilitate a society that adheres to the principles of the Nazi ideology, the secret police of Berlin is an essential part of everyday life in Berlin. Their presence is at once omnipresent and invisible. The citizens of Berlin know that their every move is being watched and, having been indoctrinated for over a decade, that it is for their own good. Most of them are perfectly fine with this. The secret police headquarters is located just a few blocks from the Volkshalle of Berlin. Volkshalle. Okay. Germania. Oh, it's from there, okay, I think. Okay, so. Serial killer on the loose, murder duo suspect. Berlin, October 11th. 1960. The rush of murders which has plagued the city for the last couple of months may be the work of a degenerate murder duo, sources close to the investigation say. So far, five people have been killed. Each victim was found dismembered and scattered throughout the sewers. Oh, Jesus. Witness reports speak of two strange men, most likely mentally and physically disabled, lurking around the crime scene. They did not look like normal, decent Berlin folk to me, says one of the witnesses. Must have been them who did this awful thing. Yes. Why Venus? Yeah, I'm a superior being. Erdmann's letter. First letter I found for in a while. 2. Father Helmut Hoffmann, the Berlin Church of the Third Reich. Third Reich. Ayashushu, Peru. 1955. That's 5 years, isn't it? Yes. Dear Father Helmut, did you know that in the mythology of the indigenous groups of Peru, the Chuchun people, there's a figure called the Pishtaku or the Butcher, They describe him as a white murderer dressed in a poncho and wide-brimmed hat carrying a sickle who extract... My phone turned on or activated the sound thing. But carry a sickle who extracts the fat from the bodies of the Cheshire he kills. It may sound strange, but I think it speaks volumes of the relationship between the indigenous people of this land and the Spanish conquerors who came here long ago. I've been thinking about the Pishtaki more and more recently, with an accompanying anger brewing in my heart. A month ago, I lived close to a family of Cretians here in Ayacucho, trying to convert them to the Roman Catholic faith. I became friends with the youngest child of the family, a boy named Hastu, which apparently means bird of the Andes. Hastu has been my guide in all things relating to the culture of the Quechuans. It's quite fascinating, even though I weep for them that they may never come to paradise unless they convert to the true faith. 2 weeks ago, I climbed the mountains of the Andes together with Hastu to visit the sacrificial grounds for the Apus, or the Apus, the mountain gods. The view from up there was breathtaking. What little breath I had left after that steep climb. I was to be an observer during this ritual to the gods, which involved the sacrifice of a llama. I was to take notes and record the strange rituals and the paraphernalia thereof. Then our soldiers came. I remember a Quechuan shaman calmly walking up to the officer in charge. The officer leveled a gun at his head and shot him clean through. I shouted at him, "What are you doing?" And he said, "Stay out of this, father. This is a sanctioned purge." They started killing indiscriminately, killing everything that walked or tried to crawl away to safety. I managed to get Hastu to run away before one of the soldiers knocked me out with the butt of his rifle. I woke up and there were no Christians left in Ayacucho. They were just gone. I searched for Hastu, but I couldn't find him. Either he was found and shot, or he managed to stay hidden up in the mountains. It pains me to see all these atrocities committed by my people. I am reminded once again of the Pishtaku, the white murderers who came here and slaughtered these people for their own evil purposes. Can you speak to someone, Helmut? Someone who can put a stop to this nonsense. This barbaric nonsense. It cannot go on, in the name of the Lord. I have packed my bag, bought warm clothes and sturdy shoes. I have even gotten hold of a gun for protection. Tonight I will go up into the mountains and search for my friend Hastu, and I hope to see a new dawn when I return. Wish me luck. Your devoted friend, Father Erdmann Kruger. Yep. And also... She looks less attractive in this than she does in the game. And it's the exact opposite for Frau Engela or something. Yes. Anja Oliva. Born to Polish doctors and intellectuals, Anja was well on her way to a doctorate in archaeology. They were, however, forced to abandon her academic pursuits. Stepping up to help with the family trade of running a mental asylum, she served as the head nurse and caretaker of the afflicted before the Nazis came and shut the facility down. And shot it down. Oof. Good thing nobody hears this. Yeah, but of course, I think it's something, you have to use the laser things to get it, I think, maybe. Maybe. Maybe, baby. Oh. I think so. Interesting. Beer, I think. Yes, beer. Oh, no, it's this.
Curious gadget. Useless without a battery.
Yeah. Laserschneider prototype. Find a strange looking doohickey. Looks like it needs a battery of sorts. Yeah. Tool for cutting through thin wire fences, chains, and other small steel objects. Cut an opening in a fence by moving the target reticle in the desired direction and make a complete shape, like a circle or square. If the laser cutter runs out of battery, it can be recharged at the power station. Hold mouse on so you can charge the laser cutter. Okay, cool. Is this a power station? No. This is something else that's used. Okay, cool. Okay. Let's go, that's a good fancy. Hold on, skits. Yes, indeed. Achtung! It's just me making that sound, so yeah. Nothing to worry about. Okay, yes. Wait, I need that. I need to use that actually. Up here. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Okay, use that. Oh, okay, I thought that was about special people. Since I first saw it in the insane asylum, but it's a astronaut. Okay, not a special person. Oh damn. Gold. Cool. Gold frame. Oh yeah. Obedience is courage. Ich muss immer die if I jump down there. Well, gonna do it anyways. Oh yeah, of course, that's just because you said that before as well, so yeah, gotcha. That's nothing new. The leader loves us all. Indeed. Maybe I shouldn't have done that to there. I shouldn't have done that. Okay. Okay then. Signal detected. But I can see him on the map. Uh-huh. So what is this place? A place where they torture people or interrogate them? Doing some renovations, I see.
Come here! Ich mach dich platt!
Come here, I'm gonna beat you. I didn't hear that. Couldn't go better, but also could have gone worse. So yeah. Oh, cool.
Ich habe die Kreissaugefangenen 16 Stunden lang am Stück verhört. Diese nächtelangen Verhöre bringen mich noch ins frühe Grab. Ich gehe jetzt nach Hause und schicke die Gefangenen zurück nach Eisenwald. Der Bus ist vorhin eingetroffen. Antworten Sie! Verdammt, Müller, Sie erwarten, dass ich Sie bei jeder Kleinigkeit um Erlaubnis frage und Sie besitzen nicht mal den Anstand, auf eine einfache Transportanfrage zu antworten. Lecken Sie mich doch am Arsch, Sie Drecksack! Sie sind eine Schande für die ganze Operation! Ich nehme keine Befehle mehr von Ihnen entgegen, verstanden?
Inside the Siberian training grounds of Moscow, October 12, 1960, located near the northern part of the Ural Mountains, not far from the Karasi, the Death Cell compound, the commando training camps are considered to be the toughest in the world. In a series of investigative reports, we reveal how these fierce combatants manage to live through their days in extreme cold temperatures, and how it makes them the superior warriors. I guess that's why the Vikings were so badass, huh? I'm just kidding. There have been a lot of badass warriors up through the times. Yay! What? Okay, what do I need this for? Oh! Nice! I was like, okay, why? But now I understand why. Nice. Red secrets. Nice. I wonder what that says. It sounds like Morse code, so I'm gonna assume it's Morse code. Nash the halt. Oh yeah, next stop, because halt means stop. Next stop, Venus. But why Venus? Well, it shouldn't, you know, Mars be the better place. I mean, they've gone to the moon, but have they gone to everything? Or have they gone to Mars and that? Mars as well, and then next stop is Venus, because that's the one. That's the closest one they haven't already taken, or I don't know. Damn it, I'm a pool man, not a doctor. It's nice music though. Jesus. Oh yeah, also, and smoking kills and stuff like that. Because, you know, I killed him and he was smoking. First German lands on moon. Wait, not Mars, moon. Berlin, July 21st, 1951. At 3:56 yesterday afternoon, astronaut Hans Armstrong okay, became the first man to walk on the moon. First contact with the moon's surface was made 30 minutes after Armstrong and his co-pilot, Emmerich Otto, steered the lunar module to its landing spot in an area known as the Glimmer Bowl. After the landing, the two astronauts began the adventure on the moon by planting the beautiful flag of the Reich. They then started collecting soil and rock samples for further analysis back on Earth. Yeah, what in real life, what did they find out about those stones and rock samples? No, smidge. Oh, damn. I mean, the soil and rock samples. Oh, yeah! Oh, yeah!
Schichtwechsel, wir sind spät dran. Eine Minute. Genau eine Minute, Hans. Da müssen wir aber los. Rechts. Geh du da. Komm schon. Vorwärts. Sau, du Dreckige, du komm vorwärts. Zeig dir was. Faule Drecksau, du komm. Komm. Faule, geh raus. Schnell vorwärts. Zeig dir was. Komm schon! Vorwärts! Vorwärts! Hey du! Noch
5 Schritte. Vorwärts.
Ich
glaube, der könnte rasten. Links rein. Rein sofort, du Drecksau, du. Rein. Rein.
Ich glaube, vielleicht später?
Hans, komm schon. Lass uns gehen.
Where the ends know and hear that the
steel. Stone. Concrete for miles. I wonder if there's anything in this world worth saving. Desolation. Tyranny. Enemy of endless might. I'm wondering if I have any friends left standing.
Well, I mean, it's been 14 years.
I'll fight alone. But I promise you this. Friends, if this is where they're keeping you, I will find you and set you free. Safe room move across the rooftop undetected. Stay off the ground.
Achtung! Gefangene für Zellblock B. Vorbereiten auf spezielle Sicherheitsprüfung. Gefangene Klasse S. Rot.
Damn. Prison. Prison. A place is crawly with Nazi guards. Need to sneak up to the roof and see if I can get the sight from there. Okay. Actually, I got one here. One out of one. Woohoo! Yay! I don't know what's that. Okay, well, I'm gonna leave it there. And hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you a lot later.